What is up, everyone? King of Over 17 here with week 2 of the 2017 Minnesota Vikings season. This is season 2 of my Minnesota Viking franchise. And today we are heading up against the New Orleans Saints. This is Monday Night Football, and this is the first home game of the season. And we will be back for kickoff. Welcome back to the broadcast, everyone. Blair Walsh back to kickoff. And here we go, the home opener. This is a packed U.S. Bank Stadium. And Blair Walsh sends that to the end zone. Brandon Cooks to retrieve it, and he takes a kneel down. Here is Drew Brees, 236 yards, one touchdown, and two picks in this opening game. The Saints are 0-1. Here's Mark Ingram, but he gets taken down by Danielle Hunter. Second and 14 now. Loss of 4. Now there's Ingram again going up the middle. Ingram having a little trouble there, but he gains about a few yards there. Going to be 3rd and 11. Here is the Saints' offensive line. This is their offense. Now they're, well, back to receivers. Brandon Cooks is the main, the biggest weapon here. Cooks is fast, and he's small. He can get past any defender. But it's going to be John Brown there who bobbles the ball up. That's 3rd down. So now the Vikings bring out Teddy Bridgewater, who was at 306 shots, 4 touchdowns, 1 interception in his season debut against Arizona last week. Great game for Teddy. And that's going to be batted down right there. Here's their defense here. Rankins is the big nose tackle here. And he gets this, their rookie, Craig Robinson, the right outside linebacker. Good rookie there. He has a bright NFL future. And they also have a rookie corner here, Kobe Fellaini. Also, he also has a bright NFL future here. But now Teddy dropping back to pass, and Teddy's going to be taken down here. That sack was given up by Barry Aikens, and we are forced to punt the ball. Barry Aikens has been seeing some ups and downs this year, and that's Brandon Cooks on the slant route, beating Xavier Rhodes on the play. That's going to be a great battle to watch. There's Ingram going to the left side, and Ingram gets about 8 on the play. But Cooks and Rhodes will be an amazing battle to watch today. Cooks is going to win some, Rhodes are going to win some, and he's going deep, and that's going to be thrown away, actually. Right, no one's in the vicinity at all, and, well, Brees got hit on that play, so he was definitely throwing away. 33 down, following the 37-yard line. And it's going to be handoff. No, play action. Brees going to his left now. He's going to dump that off to Pryor, the backup running back there. And now Brees going to the left side. There's Brandon Cooks again on the comeback route. Xavier Rhodes needs to do better with those. He's had a problem with them all his whole career, pretty much. Willie Snead and Rhodes are now facing off, and that's going to be going to Ingram, and Ingram runs to his own offensive lineman and loses yards there. That's a loss of 5. The tackle's going to go to, the credit to the tackle's going to Everson Griffin, excuse me, guys. 2nd and 15 now. Brees in the gun, Ingram to his left, and that's going to be a handoff to Ingram. He's going right. He breaks one tackle, tries to break another, well, tried to juke Trey Waynes out, but it's unsuccessful. He gets 6 shots on the play. It's 3rd and 9 now for the Saints. And Brees back to pass. Brees going left. It's going to be batted down by Xavier Rhodes there. Xavier Rhodes wins that battle with Brandon Cooks. Teddy back to pass now. Teddy's going to find the rookie Sheldon Peterson there. Sheldon Peterson had an amazing game. And look at our, this is our draft cast. All players are starters, pretty much, except Ballbridge and Wilds. But all players are playing, and they are contributing to this team. And that is Adrian Peterson with the first down run there. Gets about 3 or 4 on the play. That's going to be play action to McKinnon now. Teddy, look, he's going right, and he's going to find Stephon Diggs on the play. Stephon Diggs gets a gain of 6. C.J. Ham now in running back. C.J. Ham gets a handoff there. And C.J. Ham gets about 3 yards in play. I don't think he got the first. He did not. And that's going to be 4th and 1. And the Vikings punt. So 2nd and 8 now for the Saints. And they're going to hand it off to Mark Ingram here. And Daniil. No, that's Linval Joseph there meeting Mark Ingram. Seems that it's early right now. Early in the first quarter. Seems that no team can get a early run game. There's John Brown there. John Brown beating Anthony Barr there. Barr should not be in coverage of a receiver there. And that's Ingram meeting, well, who was that? Was that Emmanuel Lamar? I think he met
That's going to be the end of the first quarter, though. Score is both donuts, but the Saints are driving down the field. 3rd and 9 down back here in the second quarter. Saints are on the ball on the 50 yard. They're driving down this field a little bit, and now he's going to his right, and it's going to be left, excuse me. Josh Hill there, the tight end. Tight ends are a problem for us, so hopefully we can get rid of that. And there's Willie Snead. Willie Snead, he dropped the ball last second. Okay. Trey Williams was beat by Willie Snead on the play, but Jayron Kurtz laid the boom, and Snead dropped the ball. They're going to say incomplete there. That's going to be Josh Hill underneath again. Josh Hill was wide open, and that's a good enough for a Saints first down and more. 2nd and 10 now. Ball on 15. Saints now in field goal range. Breeze back to pass. Breeze going right, and he's throwing that away. There was no one open, and he felt the pressure coming. 3rd and 10 now for the Saints. Breeze back to pass once again. He's going to the end zone. That's batted away. Harrison Smith bats that away. Let's see that again. That's going to be John Brown. Yes. Harrison Smith. No, Jerron Brown. That's Jerron Brown, and he bats that away. And now it's 3-0. Saints kick their field goal. 3-0. 1st and 10 for the Vikings. Ball on the 17-yard line. Teddy back to pass, and McKinnon in it running back now. And that's going to be Adam Thielen on the first play. And he gets about 8. Peterson back in the game now. And Peterson going left, and Peterson gets about 5 on the play. It seems that the Vikings are going to continue to use all 3 running backs here and use Adrian Moore. Adrian is 32 now, and, well, the Vikings just want to use him. Oh, my goodness, Adrian took a huge hit there. Fumbles the ball, but the Vikings do get it back. 2nd and 12 now. As Teddy's back to pass. Teddy's going left. Right. Excuse me. That's going to be Sheldon Peterson, the rookie. Number 80. Rookie out of Nebraska. He's been excellent this season so far. Well, excellent in the first game. And Teddy's in trouble. And that he barely got that one away. 4 for 7. 25 yards for Teddy. Not an exceptional start here. And that's Mark Ingram. And he's going nowhere. Met by 2 Vikings there. Sharif Floyd. And looked like Everson Griffin. 2nd and 12 now. And Breeze back to pass. Breeze going to find Brandon Cooks there. And there's Emmanuel Lamar who gets the tackle on the play. 3rd and 6 now. Breeze back to pass. Breeze looking. Breeze going left. He's going to find Josh Hill. And they're going to say he was out of bounds. So, well, it's time to punt now. Morstead back to punt, and Morstead's going to kick this one deep. He's going to land right here on the 21-yard line. This is Jalen Mills now. Jalen Mills brings it all the way back to the 47-yard line. Excellent punt there. Return about 26 yards for Jalen Mills. He's going to be an explosive punter returner if he keeps this up. Teddy has a man open, and he finds Sheldon Peterson. This kid is always open. Teddy, play action there. Teddy going deep, and he finds Stephon Diggs, and Diggs holds on. Wonderful play from Stephon Diggs there. Now the Vikings are in the red zone here. Teddy look going to the end zone, and that's almost intercepted. He was looking for Peterson there. Not a good decision there from Teddy. Teddy back to pass. Teddy rolling out right, and he's going to find Kyle Rudolph there. And Kyle Rudolph should have just gone forward, and that would have been a touchdown. But Blair Walsh kicks the field goal, and that's going to be 3. The game is tied 3-3 with 4 minutes and 35 seconds remaining in the game. It's going to be a handoff to Mark Ingram now as the Saints get their possession back, and Ingram gets about 8 on the play. They're going to say he got 7. 2nd and 3 now, and the Saints like to run a dual backfield with Ingram and C.J. Spiller. C.J. Spiller in game now. But that's Willie Snead who connects the first down. Ingram back in the game now. And that's Josh Hill again. We need to get some linebackers who can do some. We need better coverage linebackers. Barr is our best coverage linebacker, and he struggles in man coverage. Barr, great in zone. Lamar, he struggles. Kendrick, he struggles. We may need to put Barr on Hill the rest of the game and have him cover a man, because Barr's not great in man coverage. 2-minute warning coming up here. But I don't know how we can stop tight ends. What can we do better to stop the tight ends? Don't want to put a corner on a tight end because that's a match of corner wins every day. And look at this. Man, that was Emmanuel Lamar there. Josh Hill was just, there he is again. And that's Kendricks. As you guys seen, all three tight ends have been on. And that's got to be neutral zone. That's got to be neutral zone right there. Looks like Danielle Hunter jumped a little bit, and it is going to be indeed neutral zone. Well, that's exactly what we needed there. He's learning, so I'll let that one pass for him. Breeze, back to pass now. Second and one now, and that's going to be caught. Sorry about that glitchy there, guys. Hope it doesn't happen again. That did not happen in game, but that's first down for Brandon Cook. Second and 10 now. Breeze going left, right. I do not know my left or right. Looking for C.J. Spiller there. Third and 10 now. Breeze back to pass. Breeze looking. He's going left. He's going to find Josh Hill, and Josh Hill gets taken down. And they're going to get another field goal there. And that's going deep, and that hits, well, a Saints man in the helmet. And, again, this is just not looking good for the Vikings. Third and 10 now. Teddy going out right. He finds Sheldon Peterson, who stretched out to catch that one. Big gain there for Sheldon Peterson there. Saints lead 6-3. And Teddy's going deep again, and he finds no one. It's batted down there. Teddy and the Vikings are looking for the big shots early. This is not their type of game. That's going to be Laquon Treadwell. It looks like Treadwell did indeed get the first down. Zimmer calling a timeout now. And they are indeed giving Treadwell the first down. Teddy back to pass now. Teddy looking. Teddy end zone. Teddy and Treadwell do not connect. As Treadwell drops the ball. And Zimmer is not happy. Third and 10 now. And they're just going to straighten this out for Blair Walsh. As Jerick McKinnon barely got it straightened out. This is a 49-yard field goal for Blair Walsh. Let's see if his struggles continue this year. And here comes Blair Walsh with his kick. And this is going to look good. The power's there. Accuracy's there. Good. 49 yards. Blair Walsh is good from. And that's going to bring us to halftime. And I will come back to you guys when we are back on the field. The game tied 6-6. Welcome back to the second half. Vikings on a 27-yard line, and they're going to hand it off to Adrian Peterson here, and that's, I think that's a good idea. Both teams are struggling rushing the ball, and, well, they're going to need something. And here's Teddy going to Sheldon Peterson again. Peterson, obviously, his favorite target here early this season. Peterson, well, he pretty much catches everything, but that was not enough for first down, so the Vikings are forced to kick it off, and the Saints will punt it off, and the Vikings are forced to, well, here's Ingram. And look at Ingram getting a... Well, big carry there from Mike Ingram right there, and that's a gain of 8. Ingram on the toss play, he had enough room there. The blocks were there, so he got a big gain of 8 there. Third and 2 now. It's going to be Ingram up the middle, and Ingram gets a first down for the Saints. Whatever the Saints did in the locker room, it has worked for their running game so far. That's going to be Breeze, and that's batted down. Sure. Jerron Curse there. I was about to say Jermaine Curse. And there's going to be Willie Snead there beating Trey Waynes again. These Saints receivers are pretty good, and our corners are good. So these are battles I'm like love to see all day. That's going to be it. No, that's going to be sacked there. Anthony Barr, Everson Griffin, both there. And Breeze, now we're 3rd and 14. Saints need to convert here. 14 to convert here. That's going to be a dump off the Willie Snead there. No, that's a dump off the Ingram there. And now Teddy takes over. 2nd and 9 now for the Vikings. And Teddy has not looked good. 10 for 22, 111 yards. What's wrong with Teddy today? Just had a big game last week. And that's going to be a Teddy's just bad decision there. He's looking for CJ Ham there. and Ham jawing it off with the Saints defender. Jerry now back to punt, and here we go. Ball on the 23-yard line, and he's going to get that to about the 24. It looked like, oh, great punt there. And it's going to get to be a gain of about 6, so ball on 31 now. So here we go. Drew Brees back to pass, and Drew Brees finds Josh Hill wide open, and Josh Hill is going to be gone here. Josh Hill, touchdown, Saints. Josh Hill completely burnt our defense there. 69 yards for the young tight end, Josh Hill. Speedy tight end, and that is the problem. It's now the Vikings with the ball again, and Peterson gets a gain of about 5 there. 3rd and 5 now for the Vikings. Teddy back to pass. He's going to find Sheldon Peterson, and this is the problem. If we rely on Sheldon Peterson too much, this is just... it's not good for us. We need a better blanket than Peterson. Well, Eric France comes in for now for the injured Kenny Vaccaro. And that's going to be a big blow to the Saints. Vaccaro, the starting safety there. And that's going to be CJ Ham up the middle. And CJ Ham gets just enough for the first down. That's what CJ Ham was supposed to do this year. Teddy looking. He finds Rudolph there. And that's going to be a gain of 4 there. Not the good. Room for, and that's going to be Stephon Diggs there. But there was not much room for Kyle Rudolph to do anything. Diggs had about 8 on that play. That's going to dump off this CJ Ham. That's more like it. Gain of 7 for Ham there as he got upended there. And that's going to be Jerick McKinnon fighting for some yards. McKinnon did get a little stronger in the offseason, and he gets the first down. 3 carries for 1 yard. So McKinnon not having the best of days. And he's going down to the end zone. That's caught! Sheldon Peterson! This ain't touchdown, Minnesota! Teddy Bridgewater went deep to Sheldon Peterson, and it was a touchdown. Let's see that again. I don't know if he made it into the end zone. One-on-one coverage for Peterson. That is not what you want to do. Let's see right here. This is the better angle. Peterson catches the ball one-handed. He's in the end zone as he was on top of... this is the best angle right here. On top of the Saints defender, that's a touchdown for the Minnesota Vikings. This game is tied up at 13. 43 seconds remaining in the third quarter. That's going to be Ingram meeting Linval Joseph. Eat, Linval, eat. And it's going to be the last play of the third quarter. And Breeze is going to find Josh Hill. Hill defended by Barr that time. And it looks like they had Barr and man coverage. Again, this is... I reckon that Minnesota, the Vikings defense, are doing everything. Zimmer is doing everything he can to stop this monster, Josh Hill, but it's just, whatever he's doing is not working. Breeze back to pass, and that's going to be, guess who? Hill. Breeze in the pistol formation now. Breeze going up the middle, and that's going to be J. Ron Brown. 2nd and 3 now, and that's going to be a handoff play action, and Breeze is in trouble here, and he finally dumps it off to Ingram there. Dumps off the Ingram. Looks like that's going to be enough for a first down. It will indeed. 1st and 10 now on the Viking 38-yard line. That's going to be Ingram there. And Ingram gets eaten up by Danielle Hunter and Anthony Barr. But here's Ingram up the middle. And he's going to fumble. Ingram took a huge shot from Harrison Smith there. And Harrison Smith recovers the fumble himself. What a play for the Minnesota Viking defense. That's exactly what they needed. A turnover. 2nd and 10 after the fumble. And there's Teddy going deep once again. That's caught. No! Diggs had it in his hand, but it was batted away. 3rd and 10 now for the Minnesota Vikings. Teddy with a little high snap there, looks like. And that's going to be batted down once again. So, it's going to be punt. Jerry's going to have to punt here. And this looks like a good punt from Jerry right there. But... we get the turnover and do nothing with it. That is not Minnesota Viking football. Brandon Cooks gets 8 yards on the return, so the Saints will start this drive from the 35-yard line. Breeze in the gun. Ingram to his left. Ingram going right with the handoff, and Ingram just gets taken down in the backfield once again. J-Ron Curse here once again. Curse has definitely improved this season, and Breeze has all the time in the world. There's him again. Trey Wayne takes him down. Ingram going up the middle there. And Ingram actually getting some yards here. So what? Definitely, whatever the Saints change in the locker room. And look at this, Ingram to the outside. Ingram on his sideline. Ingram may score here. One man to beat J'Ron Curse, and he will not. What a play for Mark Ingram. First and goal for the Saints now. And that's going to be Ingram up the middle. And Ingram still fighting. Mark Ingram coming out of nowhere in this game. Breeze back to pass and Josh Hill. And Barr saying, my bad. And, well, yes, sir, it was your bad. There's C.J. Ham on the screenplay. And C.J. Ham went back into the defender there. Not a good decision from Ham there. I think he could have got more than five, but at least he got five. And that's going to be Adam Thielen going to the left side. That's enough for a Viking first down. First and 10. Game tied at 20. And there's going to be more. It's Boehringer there. Boehringer had a huge play last week. And Boehringer makes a big one here in the fourth quarter. That's a gain of 28 for Moritz Boehringer. 20-13 is the score. 3 minutes and 42 seconds remaining. And that's going to be intercepted by the outstanding rookie, Craig Robertson. Mistake by Teddy, and that may have cost us the game. Breeze back to pass. That's a screen to Willie Snead there, and Trey Wayne takes him down. 3rd and 3 now. Vikings need to stop right here. We need to make this stop right here. 2 minutes and 54 seconds remaining in the game. Breeze back to pass. That's batted down. Batted again. That's intercepted. You cannot make this up. Intercepted by Mackenzie Alexander. That ball went everywhere, and it was intercepted by Mackenzie Alexander. Ball on the 50-yard line now, and that's going to be Teddy dumping it off to Sheldon Peterson. And ladies and gentlemen, Sheldon Peterson is officially over 100 yards. He's going to want to keep that ball as this is his first game over 100 yards. Teddy back to pass. Teddy going end zone. And that is just too far for Stephon Diggs. Diggs beating the rookie Fellaini on the play. Second down. 2nd and 10. Ball on 36-yard line. 2 minutes remaining in the game. 2 minute warning here. Teddy going deep again. Stephon Diggs beats the rookie again. Minnesota Vikings score a touchdown. And this game, we may be looking at overtime now. 1:55 remaining in the game. Teddy Bridgewater and Stephon Diggs connect for the big 36-yard touchdown. Now it's up to Drew Brees and, well, Josh Hill. Hill going out, and it's going to be Hill again. And Kendricks just wasn't watching Hill that way. So, I guess. And there's going to be Brees, and that's going to be Jerron Brown. And Jerron Brown gets a big gain there. Ball on the 43-yard line here. And Brees going back to pass. And that's going to be Jerron Brown. And Jerron Brown just got them in field goal range. 1:10 remain in the game. 47 seconds now as the Saints pretty much centered out for their kicker. And it's going to be up. And it is good. The Vikings have 43 seconds to win this game or tie it up. Teddy back to pass. Teddy looking. That's going to be batted around, and that is thankfully going to hit the ground harmlessly. Moritz Boehringer was his target there. 3rd and 10 now for Teddy and the Vikings. Teddy going deep once again. That's going to be Sheldon Peterson. You don't have to go deep every play, Zimmer. And now 4th and 10. This is do or die for the Minnesota Vikings. That's going to be caught. Stephon Diggs. First down for the Vikings. They're saying no. They're saying Diggs dropped it last minute. And he did indeed drop it. So, that's going to do it. The Saints are going to come out of here with a 23-20 game. Good game there for the Vikings and the Saints. Both teams played a great game. But the Saints were the better team today. And, well, it's going to have to, we just have to look forward to next week, guys. That's all I can say. We are looking forward to next week. Both teams are now 1-1, and well, next week we stay here in Minnesota to take on the Atlanta Falcons. So hopefully that can be a better experience for your Minnesota fans who came out here for the home opener on Monday night. Next week we'll be back here, and well, hopefully you can enjoy some football. Saints win 23-20. We won a turnover battle, but still yet lose the game. It's unfortunate, but this happens. And we only had 37 yards rushing, so. Thank you all for watching. Have a great day. Good game, Moonlight Swami.